Welcome to an episode of Clumsy and Random, the Star Wars role-playing game slash improv thing that's just kind of happens. We have a ginormous deck of the they're called adversary decks from the Fantasy Flight role-playing game. They're just basically all the NPCs you could ever need to encounter in a Star Wars role-playing game. Our players each get 3 cards, and they pick which one they want to be, and we come up with a scenario based around that. Joining us today, he's no good to me dead, it's Evan Lewis!
Hello there!
And I recognize his foul stench when he was brought on board, it's Leo Andre!
It's like a medical condition. You don't have to bring up my smell. I can't help it.
Deploy the garrison, it's Sugi from the Knights of Ren and Squad Tactics as our special guest this time.
What's going on?
Alright, that's who everybody is.
Hooray.
I'm trying out some new intro stuff.
It's good. It's approved. Stamp of approval.
Alright, Sugi, as you are our special guest, would you like to go first or last at picking a character?
Ooh, I'll go first.
Okay, I will randomly select 3 cards. First option is a marauder fugitive who happens to be a dark side user.
Interesting.
Looks like just some guy in a cloak with a red lightsaber.
So not Kylo Ren.
No.
Okay.
Second option is a Quarren agitator.
Like a rabble rouser?
No, no, like he stirs water.
Oh,
he agitates it.
I mean,
gotcha. Yeah.
He's a bartender, but he doesn't actually serve the drinks. He's just the guy who mixes them.
Oh. Ooh.
Nice. And your final choice. Also, I should mention, if you don't like any of these 3, you are allowed to scrap them all. And you get 1 random card, and you're stuck with that one.
Uh-oh. That's dangerous.
Your last choice is a death trooper. Murderous fugitive, Quarren agitator, or a death trooper.
I feel like I should be the not Kylo Ren guy.
Is it murderous or fugitive? Marauder?
All right.
Seems
you said
good.
Marauder. You said marauder the first
murderous
time.
Oh.
I could murderously marauder you.
Without the benefit of Jedi training, some Force-sensitive individuals are left confused and overwhelmed. They find delight in murder and inflicting pain and are extremely
wow.
dangerous to everyone they encounter. Even though
literally everyone.
The artwork shows with a lightsaber, the card says the equipment is a serrated vibroknife.
Ooh, all right.
Ooh,
but you
yikes.
Can use the Force.
All right, stab some people.
Okay.
Leo, you're up next.
It's going to be another bird.
Random card says an M3PO series military protocol droid.
Okay.
All right.
Count Dooku. Or random third choice, Anakin Skywalker.
Are you serious?
These are cards from the newest packs that we haven't seen before, but the newest packs have some unique characters.
Or you could named characters. What is this?
Or you could wipe them and go for a random one. M3PO series military protocol droid. They manage logistical and analytical efforts for soldiers. These droids feature chassis that are better protected than typical protocol droids, blah, blah, blah. Or those other 2 guys you probably heard of.
I don't feel like I could do Dooku or Anakin justice. I mean, to be honest.
I mean, anyone can do better for Anakin, I think.
Ooh.
Oh.
Dun, dun, dun.
Give me the, you know what? I do it every time. Just give me that 4th one.
Oh.
All right. Here comes the random choice.
Is it Palpatine?
There is not a Palpatine card. So far, the only unique characters who have cards are from the Clone Wars era. I know there's a Grievous and a Ventress.
All right, Hondo.
And Kenobi. You are, Leo, an apprentice bounty hunter.
Ooh.
Okay.
Oh, okay. That's normal.
Chaotic evil.
And Evan, option number 1. Behind door number 1 is an Imperial Gunnery Corps. guys with the dumb helmets. And yeah. They shoot big guns on ships. Choice number two. An Imperial Dungeoneer.
Like...
Also someone with a dumb helmet.
Great.
So, does he like... So he like... Explores dungeons? And
yeah,
like
he put all
treasure.
His points into
he
dungeoneering.
Tortures people.
Imperial Dungeoneers are soldiers tasked with overseeing the prisoners confined to the Empire's many dungeon ships, detention facilities, and prison worlds. They're like a jailkeeper.
Oh, I thought maybe he was really good at like disarming traps and like fighting dragons and getting their gold.
Well, you know how Disney has Imagineers? A Dungeoneer is the one who designs the dungeons. Final option. A Forsaken Jedi.
Ooh.
Trash him.
A handful of Jedi survived the purge.
What? Garbage tier.
You don't want any of these guys?
Nope.
All right.
Oh, you don't.
Give him Count Dooku.
Count Dooku's in the discard pile.
No, just shove him right back into the top.
Amidala, here I come.
Oh, yeah, there's a Padme card.
Oh, no.
Reaching into the middle of the deck and pulling out Imperial Destab Agent.
What?
What? Imperial Agent?
What is Destab? The Destabilization Branch is an infamous agency within Imperial Intelligence and is regarded by the Alliance as the most evil of all Imperial facets. The purpose of destabilization is to ensure that sufficient fear and terror grips the galactic populace such that they rely upon Galactic Empire to maintain social order and convention. Interesting.
So he's a politician.
But he has a gun.
Yeah, he's like a propaganda.
He's like a. It officer. Almost sounds like he's a terrorist to make people feel like they need the Empire. He's destabilizing places, so like, well, shit sucks. Hopefully, someone helps and saves us, and the Empire's like, we'll help make things better. That's what it sounds like to me.
So he's a Jedi.
Okay, this is an interesting. Assortment. Not a single animal in our midst.
Yeah, that is rather novel. For
no robots.
This is my. I think this is my first time playing a human since I was, smuggling drugs.
Yeah.
Well, here is the scene.
Well, I should say humanoid.
So Sugi and Leo, your characters are sitting in a cantina. It's up to you guys if you're sitting at the same table or not. You're at a cantina, just kind of chilling, relaxing. Well, at least Leo is, I would think. It's hard to get into the mind of a murderous fugitive.
Trying to stab. I need to stab something.
Hey, even they gotta eat.
It's a small town on a backwater world that is really not super important. Evan is on his freshman... tour of duty as a destabilization agent. They sent him to this little town and they said, you know what, if you can, you know, cause some ruckus here so they maybe want the Empire, then you can move on to bigger and better tasks. So it's a little town and you guys are currently in the cantina. It's evening.
I don't think me and Sugi should be sitting together. I'm just at the bar.
I don't know.
All right.
How much money you got?
How much money? I'm only an apprentice bounty hunter. I probably don't have a whole lot of money.
You look like you might have some money.
What do I even have for equipment,
yeah,
Joe?
Yeah, what do we have? Say?
Leo, you have...
You've got that murder knife.
Yeah, you have skills of perception and ranged light. You have no talents, no abilities. Your equipment is a blaster pistol and heavy clothing. Sugi, you have, like I said, a serrated vibra knife. Your abilities are dark side force user. See chapter 8 of any Star Wars role-playing core book. Your talents are... By the way, you are... If you guys are curious, Leo is a minion level character. Evan is a rival level character. And Sugi is a nemesis level character.
Oh. I don't know what that means.
That just means, like, Nemesis is kind of like you would be as powerful as a player character in a regular campaign.
Ooh.
Whereas Minion is somebody, you know, the player characters would easily be able to dispatch.
Yeah, Minions are usually you send at the players in, like, big groups.
Technically, Leo, so, if this card were being used in a campaign, it would be a group of apprentice bounty hunters, but...
Yeah. I can't role play as a group of bounty hunters.
You're a cult.
A whole group of apprentices.
You could.
Well, there's extra
we're all sitting on the same bar stool.
And you also got like brawl, discipline, melee, perception, stealth, vigilance, all this stuff. Evan, you've got deception, discipline, coercion, knowledge, core worlds, knowledge, outer rim. Your talents are, you have an improved scathing tirade. Abilities are destabilizing influence. I'll just, because we don't care too much about the rules in the show, I'm going to just let you make up what that means.
Okay.
And you have a holdout blaster.
Oh, uh-huh. Okay.
What can I get you, pal?
The bartender asks as he is cleaning the inside of an empty glass, but he's not doesn't have a cloth. He's just using his
he's hands. Just like rubbing it out with his fingers.
Yeah. He has fur.
It's
so
a
there's actually
backwater.
More fur being left in the glass.
Oh. I'm gonna go sulk in the corner.
You want another fuzzy navel? I can make an extra fuzzy.
No, I'm good. I'm good. I didn't want the first one.
Well, I appreciate that you drank it. It was very polite.
Yeah. Okay, whatever.
What about you, pal? Why the long face? Why are you looking so glum?
Well, I am on the trail of someone. Maybe you look like a guy who hears things. You know, maybe you could help me out.
Oh, just because I've got giant ears, sure.
What? That too.
It's true, I do have exceptional hearing.
I like slide a one credit chip across the bar to the bartender.
He grabs it and he slides you back a pack of space nuts.
No, this was thanks.
Anytime, that's what I'm here for. Take great pride in my job.
He's a Chadra fan, by the way. He has like a...
Oh.
So can he actually see over the bar?
He has stilts.
Oh, stilts.
He's got like a little... It's a stool with like walker legs on it. I'm entering the bar. Dramatically.
How dramatically? Let's...
And I walk up to the bar.
Okay. How dramatically? How do you? Yeah. When you say you enter the bar dramatically, I mean,
do you kick the door open? Do you?
No, it's
enter like Kramer.
I'm declaring that it's a double door,
okay.
And I use both hands to push both doors open. And the sun is shining behind me.
And the man playing the piano in the corner stops playing.
I want to roll and see if the doors like swing back and hit you in the butt. I would call this a, what do you say, agility or presence?
Presence.
Oh, sure, presence. That'll work for me.
All right, roll one green and one purple.
Okay, nice easy one. Here we go.
Poor fails. Presence.
Ooh.
Hey-o.
Okay.
Oh.
But
okay, well, you
happens.
Succeeded. You walk in, you pull off the move you wanted to do, but the doors, like, keep... swinging back and forth for longer than you thought, and they go. And it's kind of awkward.
I notice it, but I, you know, brush myself off and walk over to the bar and order some Jamba Juice.
Do you want the blue or the teal?
Mix it.
Mix it.
Let's get a load of this guy. He thinks he can handle the mixed ones.
So he like kind of pushes like a hydraulic on his stilts, kind of like on the underside of an office chair, and goes. So he kind of lowers down to his normal height, and you just hear the kind of like clinking and sloshing as he's mixing your drink.
Pretty sure he's not mixing a drink.
It's a secret.
Oh, yeah. What do you think he's doing?
Well, you don't want to know. It's family friendly. It's not family friendly. Don't worry about it.
Oh yeah?
I don't know.
As
it
you
could,
say
it,
that...
It could be something bad.
Out the window, like a... Just a normal, wholesome-looking family walks by, and they wave, and they go, hello! And then they keep going.
I need to rob them.
Okay. Like there's a deep need inside you.
Maybe stab the parents. Is their kid's name Bruce?
Yep.
Oh.
But what's his mother's name?
Martha.
That's my mother's name, too. Oh,
wow, this got awkward. Imperial scum have mothers?
The entire bar's mom's name is Martha.
Oh, dear. Is that the name of the bar?
That's the name of the bar.
That's the name of the planet, Martha. Actually.
The bouncer requires you to show proof that your mom's name is Martha before you're let in.
Well,
by the way, Evan, you are... unless you think you're cool enough to do otherwise, you're undercover, because that's kind of part of the job.
Oh, yeah.
People aren't going to want the help of the Empire if they see the Empire as the one making them need the help of the Empire.
Okay, so I don't know that.
So
nope. I'm too cool for school.
The bartender pops back up and he goes,
"Here's your drink."
It's in a really big pitcher.
Ooh.
He said mix two of them, so that's the size of two of them. It's, as you can see, it is little kind of blue and teal. I hope you don't die, but if you do, that's not our fault.
I take a giant swig of it. I start hacking and coughing, and I slam it down, and I shout very loudly to everyone else in the bar, "This guy's trying to kill me! He put poison in this drink!"
Oh, no.
I'd like you to roll a deception check.
Oh, boy. Okay. It's happening already.
You have a skill of deception 3. What is deception? Willpower?
Yeah. Presence, isn't it?
I hope it's not presence, because you have bad
whichever
presence.
One I
just need to open
higher.
A character sheet. Yeah, we'll just say it's willpower.
Okay, that's fine.
Open a character sheet if we need to check later. So you're going to roll 3 yellows and a green.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Because you are exceptionally good at being deceptive.
That's what I'm going
but
for.
But you're going to roll 4 purple.
Oh.
Because everybody knows this guy, and he's not the type of guy to just poison a feller.
All right.
Ooh, oh, my God.
I got 2 advantage, and that's it.
So you didn't succeed in convincing anybody that you're being poisoned. Everyone just thinks you're joking, and they laugh at you and go back to their drinks. And the music resumes. The bartender kind of he throws like a
I choke on one of my nuts as I'm eating it. And I'm like, oh shit, me too.
Oh, those nuts. Okay.
Yeah.
All right, guys. I get it. Old Jimbo loves poisoning people. That poison costs extra.
He winks. But
what'd you say his name was? Gimble.
Jimble.
Kimble?
Kimble. Jimble.
Jimble?
Jimble.
Okay.
I'm going to be in the back washing dishes. Just holler if you need anything.
Hey, Jimble. Jimble, come here.
Yeah, what is it?
And he goes and raises up to eye level with you.
Now, before you go in the back, you know, maybe you can help me out. I'm in town. I'm looking for somebody.
I can see you're in town.
I don't like you very much, I don't think.
I says it the ways I sees it.
I overhear them and say, he doesn't like you either.
Oh, wow.
Have you heard of any strange goings on in town? Any violent murders, say?
I mean, there was that one murder the other day where the space wains were killed. The poor little boy is an orphan.
Space
poor little Brucius. He's all on his own now. They send him up to the orphanage on the hill. It was pretty bad. They didn't even, like, steal anything. They just killed. Ever since then, that guy's been sitting in the dark corner over there picking his teeth with that knife, but I think it's unrelated.
I turn and look at what I assume must be Sugi's character that the barkeep is pointing out to me.
Hey, what are you looking at? What are you looking at?
Nothing.
That's what I thought.
I go back to eating my nuts.
You like my nuts, huh? I got good nuts, right?
Yeah, they're very tasty, very salty.
Oh no.
I'm gonna head in the back and I'm gonna mix a batch.
Good.
I turn to Leo's character and I say, "Hey, you know all that salt's gonna kill you. You know what'd be better? Here, chew some gum."
There's gum in Star Wars?
Yeah, there is. Space gum.
Oh no.
Space gum.
Are you offering him gum or are you making a reference that I don't get?
I'm offering him gum. And making a reference that you don't get.
Alright. Okay.
It's a two for one.
There you go. Stay out of trouble. Stay out of this place where they try to kill you.
By the way, deception is a cunning check.
It's all right.
Yeah, you never know who's going to get killed in this place.
As he says that, I turn and look at Sugi's character again.
I'm going to start walking over to these
guys. The mysterious guy in the corner.
All right, you saddle up at the bar next to him. Leo's in the middle.
Hey, you guys keep looking at me and saying things I don't like. Like,
yeah,
killing.
you gotta watch out. Someone around here might kill you. You never know.
Yeah, you never know.
I hear there's a murderer type in town. And I'll bet they're from here. What do you think?
I don't know. You should stop talking about my mother-in-law. You know what I mean?
Oh, I hear she's a very lovely lady. She probably doesn't come here because she'll get killed.
I start to reach into my reach for my knife. Like, slowly reach for my knife.
Could this be the first episode that ends with us all just murdering each other?
It could. This is definitely the first episode where everyone has their own entirely independent goals. So, Sugi's slowly reaching for his knife. What are you guys doing? Do you care?
I don't notice that one bit.
You know what? How about you guys do some perception?
All right.
Evan, what is perception anyways?
Cutting also.
Cunning. Okay. Evan.
Yes?
Roll three greens. And three green. I'm going to say two purple because two Leo purple. Is in between you two. Also make it a black because that drink you had is starting to kick in.
Oh, right.
And I'm willfully ignorant.
Yeah.
I need you to fail this really bad.
Yes, I am a dum-dum.
He's a freshman.
Okay, you failed. You didn't see anything. You take another sip on your
you
teal
don't
blue.
Notice squat.
Yeah, from my pitcher.
Evan, or not Evan, Leo, you said it was cunning, so roll three green. And two purple.
Oh, I totally noticed
you
him.
You see him pulling something out of somewhere. You don't know it's a knife, though. Because it hasn't come all the way out yet. But, you know, it's rather suspicious.
All right, so I'm going to use my my sleight of hand. And instead of grab my knife, I'm going to grab my business card, which is right next to my knife.
That's handy.
Because, yeah, no one knows the difference. And I'm like, all right, here's my card. I hear you looking for some help for some kind of murderer guy. I might be able to help you for a fee.
Leo, you pick up the card. What does it say?
Yeah, what does it say?
It says, "Don't worry about it. I'll take care of it."
That's it.
Wow. Very professional. It was done on a VistaPrint.
Impressive credentials.
It's embossed. You tilt it back and forth in the light.
Yeah, it's embossed.
It's a hologram.
It's
an 80s hologram.
Yeah.
I pull out my business card and hand it back to him.
What is this?
And it says It says Klieg O'Marin, apprentice bounty hunter.
Oh, okay.
And it's got my email address on there. Twitter handle? Space Twitter.
At space, yeah, it's AOL.com still.
Yep. Spacetagram.
Facebook.
Mine is not embossed. It's like, you could tell it's been printed off like my inkjet printer at home. and like
it's
those like
perforated edges.
Yep.
All right. I see you got taste with your business card here. I appreciate that. What's with the fuzzy navel over there? It was about to fall off of his bar stool.
I don't know fuzzy navel over here. What I do know. No, I take more nuts though.
Oh God!
I'm working on the nuts. Working on the nuts here. I'll be on a little bit.
I don't know this guy over here, but I am. I'm in town. If you think you could help me, I'm in town.
Well, you got to say that twice. It's not like news.
Well, you were over there. You might not have heard me.
You said it twice right now.
He's in town here.
Oh, I'm going to hurt someone.
See, nobody cares. But it's dangerous here. Anyone could get killed. It's dangerous.
It is dangerous.
Yeah,
there's a murderer.
Is.
In town, and I am trying to track him down.
Oh, boy. Well...
Yeah, you never know where you'll run into him next.
Somebody... Not the bartender, the... Somebody else just kind of stumbles by and goes, Did you guys hear about the murder the other day?
What about the murder?
The dead people.
Yeah. What about that?
How drunk is this guy? Can I do a perception check?
Or is you don't just... need it. He's pretty drunk.
Okay, I'm going to try and steal from him.
Okay. Let's call that agility.
Okay.
So, 4 green. Roll a purple and a red because I have an idea of if you roll a despair.
Oh, dear. Anything else?
Nope.
Bloop. All dice have canceled
just
out.
Nothing. You, like, reach towards him, but he's swaying so hard. It's like he's dodging you on purpose, but he's not.
Bummer.
What are you trying to shake my hand? All right. He grabs your hand and he's like, nice to meet you. I really hope that you don't get murdered because, you know, this murders around here. They, you know, this town's called Martha, but they should call it... Murder.
You don't say, murder, old man. Yeah. You don't say.
I mean, I've been in this town for at least 7 years, and in all my time, there's been a couple murders at, you know, kind of the average rate, and it doesn't help that there's no law. If only someone would catch the murderer. It's not me, though. I got places to be. And he kind of saunters off into the corner, and he keeps drinking.
I pick up my nuts, and I'm going to go sit down with this guy.
All right. Hey, nice nuts.
I offer a nut to this man.
Oh, I would love your nut. Now, there's one thing they say about old Cranky Joe is that he loves a nut. That's not me, though. My name is... Drunk Mr. Bunk. But I also love a nut. If there's one thing that this town is known for, it's most people's mothers are named Martha. People get murdered every now and then, not alarmingly fast, but you know, not never. And we love nut. What can I do for you?
I'm here tracking down the murderer you mentioned. What can you tell me about him?
Oh, he likes to kill people.
That's it?
Well, I mean, he doesn't leave too many witnesses, except that Brucius kid who's holed up at the old orphanage now. He's actually the only orphan. We didn't have any orphans before, so we just... stuck him in the shed on the hill.
Oh, wow.
All right. I think he'll be okay. All right. Well, I'm leaving the bar to
see that fella at the bar right there?
Yeah.
See what he's wearing? He's wearing some cloak and kind of like a cape, but not a cape, and it's got a hood, and he's got some pants. And like, it's essentially exactly what he's wearing, clothes like that, is what I heard. That's the word on the street.
What is this?
Whoa there. Freddy, stop ripping fingered. That nut so hard. You busted that nut.
Oh my god.
Oh my gosh. I need to kill this guy. He's spreading the lies.
Well, then I guess I'll go back to my place at the bar.
Man, yeah, apparently hey. Me and Fuzzy Neighbor the are talking.
Nice meeting you. Did you want... before you take my business card.
Yeah. Hey, it says Drunk Bunk on it. He
drunk
loves,
Mr. Bunk.
I love a good nut.
Oh boy.
I'll sit back down in my bar stool. Hey, Bunk over there says you're dressed just like the murderer.
And?
Yeah, that makes you a target for the murderer.
And so I would like to know, where did you buy your clothes? I need to, they might have seen the murderer at that shop.
I don't know. You ever heard of Wakanda Forever 21?
At that precise moment, Drunk Mr. Bunk, his head just slams down on the table. Like, the joke might have killed him, you're not quite sure.
And I slam the drink down and say, okay, everyone, look, this is what happens. We're going to have Imperial authorities in here to take care of this man who's just been murdered in this... place in this town. See, that's his death rattle. He is dying. This is Russian vodka, poisoned by Chernobyl. He's dying. We need to bring the stormtroopers in here now. Everyone get ready. Everyone get your papers ready, your identification. We're going to have Imperial forces rolling down the street here any second now. It's the only way any of you are going to be safe. You could be next. How do you want to die? Do you want to die?
I'd like another... we're going to go with coercion this time.
Perfect.
Coercion's will, yep.
While Fuzzy Navel's making a huge display and drawing attention to himself, I'm going to go try and rob Mr. McDrunk over there.
Okay, I will need a skill check from you.
Or at least to stab him a couple times while no one's watching.
Just to prove my point.
We'll just fix this problem I'm having.
Let's see if you can convince everybody that they need Imperial rule.
Okay.
You said coercion is willpower.
Please do, so I can make this killing happen very quietly.
These things are actually happening simultaneously while Evan is yelling. So roll 3 yellow, 1 green... let's call it 2 purple and a black.
I need you to succeed big time.
Black because you're still kind of drunk.
Yeah, I'm a trying. Hell! Well, I'm very loud.
You definitely were very loud. People were paying attention to you. They're not quite buying that they need the Empire just because a couple people died.
What is that, 2 advantage?
3 advantage.
3 advantage.
What's the upside down Y? Are the... The why? What is that?
That's the failure.
Okay.
So he failed, but people definitely have his attention enough for you to attempt to rob and or stab that guy.
Mm. And I'm gonna.
They
pass
are
along
considering
one of those
your point, Evan, but they don't quite buy it.
Okay.
All right. Since he hasn't gotten everyone's attention successfully, I'm just gonna steal from him. I don't think I can get away with a killing here.
Let's go with the agility again. Roll 4 green and 1 purple.
If I fail here, I'm going to cry. Oh, super pass.
Whoa.
You succeeded immensely. You found...
All right.
5 nuts.
Two, a stack of business cards.
Oh, no. And a half credits. A stack of his business cards. Oh, a small furry creature that you can't tell if it's dead or just sleeping.
It's a tribble? You found a tribble in Star Wars.
It's happening.
No, it's more like a mouse.
It's working. Oh, okay. I'm going to name it Newt.
It's working.
It's working. It's working. All right, I have a new pet that works. I like this.
Sweet. It's a chinchilla.
Is that it?
And you, there was a note inside.
Oh, I'm assuming that's not relevant.
You'll never know till you read it.
All right, I will. I'll keep the nuts, the note, and my new pet.
There was a couple credits. He said, didn't you?
There are 2.5 credits.
Two and a half. I'll take 2.5 credits.
Okay.
And I'll spit his like drink.
Did the animal eat half of one of the credit chips?
Yeah, it's definitely, there's like chew marks on the metal credit coin.
I'll put the animal on my shoulder so it can't eat my credits.
It's still like kind of passed out not, but I mean it'll balance on your shoulder, but
okay.
It might just look like there's a dead rat on your shoulder.
I'm okay with that. Because now I definitely don't look like that guy who I didn't look like that didn't kill Bruce Wayne a thing.
Yeah, the space buttons.
Jimble comes out from the back. He's got a huge sack. And he... he hefts it onto the bar and goes,
"Fresh nuts! I got more nuts. Why? Hey, you new guy. You out of towner. I heard you speaking a ruckus about the Empire. What are you talking about? We don't need that in here.
I'm talking about the threats that you have that are coming from off-world into here, spreading their hate and violence, and you need Imperial protection, and you need it now.
You know what? All right, you're going to try and...
Here we go again.
This is going to be a deception this time. Well, Evan, do you think it's coercion or deception?
It's coercion, because I believe this.
Oh, no.
3 yellow, a green, because you have coercion 3 and your willpower is 4. Make it 2 purple and 2 black, because you are getting drunker.
Spicy.
You succeeded with 2 threats.
Oh, wow.
So you have convinced him that, you know what, maybe we do need the Empire here. But you're also like starting to like try and suppress throwing up.
You know what? Maybe if the Empire... I heard that there's never any murders when the Empire is around.
Yeah, you... heard... Right.
There's a bucket in the corner.
I don't need... And I run past the bucket towards the men's bathroom.
Oh, dear.
But it's not the men's bathroom.
Uh-oh.
It's the lady alien's bathroom.
Okay, well, you burst open the door. I'm assuming you're just going to go straight into one of the stalls.
Oh, yes.
I'd like, I don't think this is a thing, but I just want some luck. I want to see how your luck is. I want you to roll 1 yellow and 1 red.
Say again?
1 yellow and 1 red. This will determine, exactly what happens in that stall.
Ooh. Oh,
what is happening?
I
get to the
you
stall.
Succeeded with a threat. Yeah, you get in there, you blow chunks all over the stall. There's nobody else in there. In that stall, there was somebody in the bathroom, and the vomit is like splattering on the floor. And she goes, "What the fuck?" And she just kind of leaves, and from like outside the door you hear her going, "Somebody's blowing chunks in there, guys.
Hooray.
You're gonna need to clean that up, Jimble." And you hear him go,
"God dang it. Not everyone around here can hold their nuts."
Jim was all like, I hear that there's, when they, where the Empire is, there's no vomit to clean up, you know. Oh.
What do you guys want to make an extra 5 credits?
What do you want?
Well, I don't have a map. So if someone wants to go in there and clean that up, you know, drinks on me.
5 credits and drinks? All right. I'm going to walk over to Drunk McBurk.
Oh, my God.
So you walk off, and Jimble says to Klieg.
Says, oh, man, that was a close one. You see how I clean cups. I didn't want to have to clean the floor.
I'm gonna go grab the drunk guy's coat and just use that as the mop.
So you bring it into the bathroom, yep. And
I just throw it on top of the vomit.
Well, Evan is still on his knees in front of the toilet.
I throw it over Evan.
Thank you.
Then I walk out.
And then he murders.
No,
them.
No.
And then he
no,
murders. Not yet. Oh,
we need this strange fuzzy naval man. I didn't say it was the murderer. Who said it was the murderer? You're assuming.
You're right.
He's a different murderer.
I'm just a little psychotic. There's a difference. I'm not a psychopath.
Jimble has grabbed a big handful of nuts and he's walked over to where drunk Mr. Bunk is. And he throws some on the table. And he comes back.
I need my 5 credits and a drink.
Yeah, all right.
He slides you a 5 credit chit. Yeah.
What kind of drink you want?
Mountain Dew. Space Mountain Dew.
Is Mellow Yellow
that's
okay?
Fair. Oh, it's one of these places. I know what kind. Yeah, fine, whatever.
I mean, ever since that Coca-Cola Corporation started spreading out of Black Spire Outpost, you know, they've kind of taken over.
I heard there's some kind of Walter Disney taking over the place. It's crazy. Sick of that guy.
Yeah. So do you want a Mellow
Yellow?
Yeah,
I'll have the Mellow Yellow. It's fine.
All right, with or without acid?
yes.
All right, I'm going to put half acid, half no acid. All right,
sounds good.
So he hands you the drink.
Do you need anything else? Did I hear your name was Cleve?
Nope.
Clement? Nope. Clarence?
Nope.
My name's Klieg.
Oh. Dad, did you need anything else?
Yeah, I'm good.
No, I was talking to Klieg. Oh. Can't you see where I'm looking?
I feel like this character has, like, 3 eyes. I'm like, no, I can't.
He's a grand. He's a grandeur fan.
At this moment, drunk Mr. Bunk actually falls out of his chair and onto the floor, and I'd like the two of you who are at the bar to roll a perception check.
I think he's about to die. It's happening!
Sugi, your perception is... What is that, cunning? I forgot, what is perception, cunning?
Yep.
Okay, so roll it yellow, green, purple.
All right, I should pass this easily. I do!
You succeed. So you immediately notice that there is blood coming out from underneath him where he fell.
Okay. No more.
Your advantage
Chipotle.
Is you notice it is coming from his abdomen region somewhere.
Oh. Ooh, this man been stabbed.
Well, stabbing in my bar.
Well, I don't get to roll.
Okay, you can see it, you see it too.
I'm just gonna yell really loud. Be like
yellow, green, purple.
Really? For me too? Mine's that
you have a perception skill.
We're pretty good at this thing.
All right.
You see the bleeding, but you think it's just his drink.
Okay.
You see a dark liquid coming out from underneath him, because you succeeded with a threat.
Okay, yeah. Got it.
So I'm gonna yell real loud. It looks like this man's been stabbed.
The piano comes to an abrupt halt, and there's a record scratch noise. All the other patrons in the bar look up and they go,
how do you know?
I point at Leo and I was like, that guy was hanging out with this drunk for about 5 minutes, and then when he walked away, he fell over and looked like that. What?
Ooh, all right, I need a...
It's this rotten bounty hunter who's trying to kill us off and take money.
I want a deception check.
You been a bounty hunter you can trust?
Roll 4 green and 1 purple. These guys are very trusting.
All right. Oh, yes.
They're like, oh.
Well, you know what? Mammy always told me that bounty hunters was no good, and we shouldn't let them into our town. And then one day we said, hey, fellow, you can come on in. And then all of a sudden, drunk Mr. Bunk is dead. And my mom always said that what was going to happen. And we should get him. We should hire a bounty hunter to get him. Wait a minute.
Jimble raises his stilts an extra foot, so he's actually the tallest one in the room. Now he's like,
you know, hold on now, everybody. We don't got no proof that not he.
Now,
you
know, skater.
We don't want to. Let's not lose our heads here. He ain't hurt nobody.
Everyone is kind of looking very on edge, and they're.
I finally come
out
of the bathroom with a coat still around me.
You're rather covered in vomit.
I am, and I declare there has been.
Oh no.
A murder!
Another one?
I walk very, you know, very strong steps over to the body. And I look at him, and I declare, this man is dead!
Are you a doctor?
Yeah. You know what? We already figured it was the bounty hunter over here.
Yeah, the bounty hunter.
What do we got, what do I got to do, like a counter coercion roll or something?
Well... Say your piece, and then we'll see what happens. All
right, while everyone's trying to finger the bounty hunter, I'm going to, like, slowly back off out of sight.
Yeah. I'm like, you know, I'll be like, you know, there is one man in this bar who is dressed like the murderer that people have seen around town, and it's not me, it's... And I turn to gesture... over toward Sugi's character, and he's not there.
You were saying?
It's... He was right here. You saw him,
ooh,
too.
No, I didn't... I don't recall.
Look, I've got his business card right here. It says...
And
it says
blank.
All right, well, it doesn't have his name on it. It just says, I'll do whatever you need. But, I mean... That's pretty damning, I would say. You know?
Oh, I think he was, I hate to be impolite, but he was the town prostellator. What is the word again?
Proselytizer?
Oh, no.
You know what? It says I'll do what you need. You know what he means by that, right?
Yes, he will do what needs doing to protect this town. That's what he means. We need more people like that guy.
Well, no, but all right. I ain't going to get
pull
it.
Yourself up by your bootstraps, close the borders, roll in the tanks. That guy knows what's up.
So while they're doing all this, I took my drink with me, and I'm going to turn it into a Molotov and light fire to the bar.
Okay. I'll just, yeah, you do
so
that.
So there's some fire happening in the, you know, wherever...
Did you throw it into the big area where everyone is, or somewhere no one can see?
Well,
okay.
His mellow yellow Molotov. Yep.
Whoa, what is this? What is this? Everybody, stay calm.
And I continue to say, this is what happens.
See what happens, Larry?
This is what happens when you open the borders, you get flaming drinks all over the place.
The fire is spreading, but everyone is kind of like still kind of just standing there, like wondering what to do.
Everybody, try it. I don't know. What do we do? My bar's never burnt down before.
I've drawn my blaster, and I'm looking for the culprit. Trying to see if I can see who threw it.
I'm gonna like, walk up and grab Evan and Leo and be like, we should probably get out of here. We need to talk business.
You're right. We need to find the murderer.
You put your arm around both of them, but when you put your arm around Evan, you immediately regret it and let go of him and, like, shake the vomit off you.
It goes squish. It's a squishy noise.
Everybody just pour your drinks on the fire or pee on it or something. this is business hours. I can't afford this.
Oh,
the guy at the piano is playing a very scary song. He's just getting real into it. He's just been kind of playing along with whatever's happening.
So I feel like he's playing like the Benny Hill theme. It's like everyone's running around trying to put out the fire. He's playing Yakety Sax.
So you three are due to go with the unnamed guy.
Yeah, sure.
Yes. We follow his lead.
Okay, you guys leave the bar, and you're kind of out back in the alleyway.
Well, then do the...
There's just trash there.
Do the stormtroopers ever roll up?
Are there stormtroopers on this planet?
Yeah, no, I don't think so.
You haven't yet reported to your superiors that the planet is in a state where they will be accepting of it.
Okay. I try to pull on my communicator, and...
I want you to roll a check for that, because you're pretty turned.
and slimy.
Oh,
yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Drop it.
So, pulling out your communicator should be very simple.
Yeah,
I would say two green and one purple, but throw on two black for your drunkenness.
Uh-huh. That's brutal.
And another black for your sliminess.
Heyo!
Hey, oh wow!
Succeeded. You pulled it out, but you got a lot of vomit in it.
I can't do anything.
You can't
right.
quite turn it on.
I get vomit.
It's slipping around in your hands, but you managed to hang on to it.
Imperial communicator, huh?
You put it, and well, you turn it on, but it's on speaker.
Hello?
You?
Can you hear me?
What's your name again? Sorry.
Walrus.
I lost my phone. Walrus. Agent Walrus.
Yes. Are you there?
Yes, this is. High command.
Can you hear me?
How goes the mission on planet Martha?
I thought that was the name of the town.
It is.
The name of the town, the bar, and the planet.
It's like New York, New York.
Oh, we don't talk about that.
The planet is ripe for saving by glorious empire.
Can you confirm? Can you, send some footage or get some testimonial from a citizen.
I hand it to Sugi.
Oh, hi.
Hello, citizen. This is Colonel Suspender.
Okay. Hey there, Colonel.
With the Imperial... You know, it's not important. How do you feel about the Empire? On a scale of 1 to 10, would you recommend the Empire to a friend or to your town or planet?
Don't worry about it.
Don't worry about what?
Yeah, exactly.
You don't need the Empire?
I mean, no.
Have you tried the Empire?
No.
How likely are you to try the Empire?
What is this, some kind of survey?
I mean, yeah, we gotta, like, prioritize expansion somehow. Come on, man.
No.
When we're done here, can you give me five
stars? I'm just going to close. I'm just going to close the communicator.
Okay, just, close it.
How are you enjoying the Imperial app?
Imperial scum. I hate these guys. What is a scrub like you working for these idiots?
I did it for college money.
I I'd like all of you to roll a perception check, please.
Oh my.
Sugi, you are going to roll 2 yellow, 2 green, and 3 purple.
All right. I perceive it.
Okay, Leo, you are going to roll 1 yellow, 2 green, and 3 purple. You failed to perceive it, but you do notice that Sugi's character notices something. And Evan, you are going to roll 3 green, 3 purple, and 3 black.
Oh boy, here it comes. If he succeeds...
Oh!
You failed, close. But
you noticed that Leo noticed.
So, Sugi, what you noticed is that the music inside stopped.
Ah. Seems that what my happened? Diversion worked. We'll check for the dead bodies later. We'll loot them. In due time. Don't worry about it.
You're right.
Oh, we need to sober up Fuzzy Navel over here first before we can talk business.
Do we have that much time?
It's almost midnight, and at midnight the planet has spores that make everybody go to sleep.
How much time we have?
When is the sporing hour?
About 5 minutes.
Okay. We'll have to continue this next week.
There's never a serial clumsy and random. They always have a conclusion.
Oh, gosh. I guess I'll just try and stab them in the...
All right.
I'll just try and mug them while I've got them here. Because Evan's down for the count.
I'm probably not paying attention. Yeah, because I'm probably like I noticed Sugi noticed something, you know, over there. So now I'm looking over there trying to figure out what he noticed, you know.
So I'm gonna try and put the knife in his back real quick.
All right, let's just make a combat check. You have a serrated viper knife. It's melee. Your melee skill is 4. Is melee agility or brawn?
Brawn?
So if his melee is 4 and his brawn is 3, he rolls 3 yellow and a green.
Mm-hmm. Correct.
Against, what, 1 purple? Yeah, go for that.
All right, let's see if I... Ooh!
No!
Oh! 2 successes, 2 advantage, and a triumph. I say you can describe in as much or as little detail as you want exactly what you have done to Kleeg, the apprentice bounty hunter.
Yeah, well, for the sake of the spores, we'll just give him a nice stab in the back, slash to the neck.
All right.
And Evan, I want you to roll a perception.
3 green, 3 purple, 3 black.
3 green.
This is going to end poorly.
Yeah. I'm going to call it 1 purple because it's literally in your field of vision. But still 3 black. So 3 green, 1 purple, 3 black.
Oh! I see it.
He does see something.
A disadvantage.
I am so taken aback. You kind of stumble backwards over like some garbage and fall on your butt.
As I'm crumpling to the ground and dying, I'm going to be like, I knew it was you the whole time.
All right, I'm going to attempt to pick up this blaster and shoot Evan.
Well, actually, okay, go for it.
All right, what am I rolling here?
You pick up his blaster. His blaster was...
I just had a blaster pistol or something.
Yeah, ranged light. You don't have ranged light skill.
So then it's agility, yep.
Yeah, it's 4 green, 2 purple.
Oh, I failed, but I have
you
advantage?
You missed with an advantage. So this is what happens. You stand there, you miss a couple times. Evan backpedals even more. He's basically kind of laying in a pile of garbage bags and stuff. The door to the alley swings open, and Jimble is standing there. He's holding a giant knife, and he's covered in blood.
Oh, no. Oh, God. It's him.
And he looks up at you, and he looks down at the body of Klieg, and he looks back at you, and he smiles, and then he looks over at Junior Officer Walrus. He winks at you, murderer man, and starts slinking towards Walrus, and it fades to black, and it says, created by George Lucas.
He knows how to write an ending, at least.
Teach me the ways, master. Oh, man.
Wow. Jimble was the other person who visited drunk Mr. Bunk at his table.
You're right. You're right. He was.
I knew it. I knew it. I just didn't want to say anything.
That is our show. Thank you, Evan. Thank you, Leo. And thanks very much to Sugi for joining us this time. I hope you had fun. I hope the listeners got a chuckle. I hope George Lucas wasn't listening.
I don't know. Maybe he'll take that to heart.
It's a lot more.
Oh, I mean, we need a bit more,
nuts. More nuts.
More Jar Jar.
I think it would be
pretty great if Jar Jar got his hands on some nuts. Why is everybody laughing? That's gonna do it. Evan and Leo, you don't have to say anything. Sugi, where can people find you on the internet if you want to be found on internet?
You can find me all over the place, but we do a podcast called The Knights of Ren, where we talk about Star Wars Destiny. It's a trading card and dice game. It's a lot of fun. You should check it out. And then I also do a podcast about Warhammer 40K Kill Team. It's a skirmish game, not too different from, you know, Star Wars universe, but it's a nice, fun miniatures game that people can play. It doesn't cost an arm and a leg like, you know, some of the bigger, more expensive games. So just all kinds of fun stuff. You can check out Squad Tactica or The Knights of Ren. Those are the two shows I do.
Cool. Sounds good. Thanks, everybody, for watching. Keep it clumsy. And yeah, they were watching with their mind's eye.
Like old-timey radio.
There's a lot of blood, everybody.
There's the one fan out there who's going to hand animate this whole thing.
I hope so.
No, they're just going to use Flash like all the kids do these days.
Good night.